Today is your English class and I am going to teach you English grammar, chapter number 4, nouns. In this chapter, we are going to learn that what are singular and plural nouns, masculine and feminine nouns, countable and uncountable nouns, proper and common nouns, collective nouns and abstract nouns. Okay, so let's start with singular and plural nouns. So what are singular nouns? Singular nouns refer to one person or thing. Singular nouns refer to one person or thing. For example, ox, fly, fox, key, box, bus, life, city, wolf, man, foot, shelf. They all are singular nouns. Okay. Now the second one is plural nouns. Plural nouns refer to more than one person or thing. For example, ox, oxes, fly, flies, fox, foxes, key, keys, box, boxes, bus, buses, lives, lives, city, cities, wolf, wolves, man, man, foot, eat, shelf, shelves, baby, babies, thief, thieves, brush, brushes, bench, benches, and etc. Okay, so singular noun refer to one person or one thing, and plural nouns refer to more than one person or thing. Now, the second one is masculine and feminine noun. So, masculine nouns are the names of males. What is masculine nouns? Masculine nouns are the names of males. For example, king, prince, man. Okay, they are masculine nouns. Let's take the examples from here. Prince, gender, brother, nephew, husband, peacock, gentleman, bridegroom, grandfather. They all are masculine nouns. King, hero, papa, cock, uncle, drag, horse, grown, father, man, bull, boy, lion, god, dog, son, fox, sir. They all are masculine nouns. Okay. Now, the second one is feminine nouns. Feminine nouns are the names of females. Feminine nouns are the names of females. For example, mother, girl, daughter, cat, lioness. They all are masculine nouns. Okay. Some nouns are used for both males and females. We call them nouns of the common gender. And what we call them? We call them nouns of the common gender. For example, baby, child, pupil, friend, cousin, person, and can be like feminine or masculine. Doctor can be male or female. Student can be male or female. Baby can be baby's daughter, baby's son. Child can be girl or boy. Okay, so like this. Now the next one is countable and uncountable nouns. Okay, so what are countable and uncountable nouns? For this, we have to read this table chart. Countable noun refer to those nouns which we can count them. Countable nouns are those nouns which we can count them. Like 6 dogs, 10 nips. We can count 6 dogs, 10 nips, 2 zips, 5 cars, 1 rose, 4 fans, 9 cups, 3 jugs, 8 eggs, 7 hens, 11 kites, 12 pens, 13 cats and 14 guns, which we can't count. The next one is proper or common nouns. So what are proper nouns? Proper nouns are special names for particular persons, places or things. Proper nouns are special names for particular person, places or thing. For example, Rajan, Delhi, India, Himalayas, Ganga, Gita, Taj, etc. The names of towns, cities, countries, buildings, mountains, rivers, oceans, days of the week, months of the year, titles of books, films and plays are all proper nouns. Okay, the names of towns, cities, countries, buildings, mountains, rivers, oceans, days of the week, months of the year, titles of books, films and plays are all proper nouns. A proper noun always begins with a capital letter. Always remember, students, that a proper noun always begins with a capital letter. Now, the second one is common noun. Common nouns are the names that can be used for all person or things. Common noun that can be used for all the person or things of the same kind. Like man, book, tree, flower, etc. Like man, book, tree, flower, etc. Okay, so now the next one is abstract noun. Abstract noun are words that refer to some quality, state or activity. What is abstract noun? Abstract noun is a word that refer to some quality, state or an activity. For example, beauty, courage, fear, joy, laughter, theft, silence. We can form abstract nouns from some word like move, movement, young, youth, thief, theft, poor, poverty. Okay, so student, the chapter has finished. Now I will give you some exercises. Which you have to fill it in your grammar book or do it in your grammar copy. Thank you.